Welcome friends, welcome to the new generation tax, that is goods and services tax. I'm really glad to address you on the topic that is goods and services. This is a very revolutionary step, laudable step, wonderful to see finally that India has joined the club of GST, that is a value added, an advanced version of value added taxation system. In fact, GST is nothing but a value added taxation system, but it is the advanced version. All over the world, if you look at countries like France, no doubt they are in an advanced stage and we have joined them. Now, around 160 countries have adopted and have been following the value added taxation system, and of course in India also we have been already there. We introduced the value added taxation system way back in 1987, partly for excise, and again in 2002 in services, and again 2005 in sales tax, and finally now we are through a thorough system of value added taxation in 2017. With effect from 1st July 2017, we have this goods and services tax. Let's move to what is GST. Come on, because there is a lot of discussion on GST, televisions, newspapers, even websites, social media, everywhere. This is doing rounds. Everybody now knows there is some taxation system which is called GST, that is there, that has been introduced in India. But the thing is, details. Not many people would be knowing the details, but they at the most they know that it's a tax. So I would like to throw a little more light on that. What is a GST? I'm not discussing from a layman's point of view, but from a technical point of view. So it is an indirect tax. See, what is a GST? It's an indirect tax. So that I'm not introducing anything new. Everybody knows what is an indirect tax. Tax may be a direct tax or indirect tax. When the tax burden is shiftable, when the tax burden is shifted, that is indirect tax. Okay, so what about the indirect taxes that we have in India? Most of the taxes have been replaced by this GST, subsumed. So basically GST is an indirect tax, needs no elaboration. Second point is, see, look at the second point. It is a tax on goods and or services. It is a tax on goods and or services supplied in India. So one thing is, see, goods, it's a tax on goods, or it's a goods on services, or it is on both goods and services. Suppose you are using a mobile, you are paying service tax. So practically now you pay GST. In the place of service tax, now you pay GST. Suppose some goods were sold by X to Y. That's a sale of goods. Here in this is a case of goods. So earlier it was sales tax, now you are paying GST. Similarly, somebody manufactured goods and manufactured and cleared the goods, supplied goods to somebody from his factory. So earlier it was excise duty, now it is GST. So whether it is manufacture, whether it is sale of goods, it doesn't matter. You have to pay GST, not excise, not sales tax. Similarly, earlier for services you are paying service tax, now you pay GST. So simply speaking, whether it is goods or whether it is services, at the time of supply, when they are supplied, See, the word supply is very significant, very important here. So, when you supply goods or services or both, you have to pay GST. Both, what could be the situation of both? It's very simple, easy. Suppose you go to McDonald's, Pizza Hut or a restaurant. You order certain food items. So on those food items, you have been paying service tax and also VAT, right? Now you don't have to pay service tax and VAT, you simply pay GST. So it is a case of both goods and services, because a particular activity, particular service in a restaurant, etc., etc., it is a case of service, it is a case of sale of goods. For both, now you pay only GST, not two taxes. One tax VAT to state government and another tax to service central government. So even the trader, the dealer or whatever it is, the SSC you can say, had a trouble. So VAT he has to deposit with the state government, service tax he has to deposit to the central government, that is, it has become a headache, number of interactions or interfaces with the different officers. Now he will simply pay GST and with one single authority he will settle the issue and he will file a return to one single authority. Like this, simplified one. So it is, GST is a tax on goods or services or both. Similarly, see the case of works contract. So in works contract, of course, I am talking about immovable property. So because in the GST, works contract relating to immovable property is done away with, unfortunately. It is unfortunate, it should have been done. But as far as immovable property is concerned, when there is a works contract, there is an element of service and there is an element of goods. Now both are clubbed together. In the case of works contract relating to immovable property, you are simply paying one tax, that is GST. No service tax, no VAT or CST. So, but when? So important thing is, you see, supply. Goods and or services supplied in India. Supplied in India implies there is a supply, means there is a delivery, there is a movement. There is a delivery, then only it is supply. Of course, Act provided what is supply and what includes supply, what is not supply, free supplies, supply for consideration, all these things have been considered, have been clearly specified in the Act, in the bill. The thing is, at the time of supply, the tax becomes leviable, means supply is the taxable event. Earlier, it was manufacture, it was sale, it was service, provision of service, etc., etc. There are so many other things also. All those things have gone. So many taxes have been subsumed by a single tax, GST. That's the reason why you can say one nation, one tax. That is the slogan by government. One nation, one tax is really true. It is only one tax, GST. Maybe it's a combination of different components. State GST, central GST, something like that. Nevertheless, it is one tax. So, supply is the taxable event. Okay? So, when there is a supply, when the supply happens to be in India, whether it is supply of goods or supply of services, automatically the GST becomes payable, subject to exemptions, if any. So, it's a case of supply.